All right, ladies and gentlemen, how is everybody doing? Welcome to CBS Den, and yes, this is yet another tutorial. I'm going to try to make it as quickly as possible because I have a lot to cover here. What's it about? Well, a lot of people keep asking me questions about voice. As a matter of fact, you know, people keep asking me pretty much anything. मुझे कभी कभी लगता है उनको लगता है कि मैं विकिपीडिया या गूगल या यूट्यूब में से एक चीज हूँ बट सी आई डोंट नो एवरीथिंग और मे बी आई डू बट आई डू नो अ फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट वॉइस ओवर्स बिकॉज आई हैव बीन डूइंग वॉइस ओवर्स फॉर अबाउट ऑलमोस्ट 15 इयर्स नाउ ऑलराइट नो एग्जैजरेशन एंड या पीपल कीप कमिंग टू मी अबाउट यू नो क्वेश्चंस एंड डाउट्स दैट दे हैव एंड आई थॉट दैट यू नो maybe I should just make a list of the things that will help a lot of you, not just now, but at any time that you watch this video. So, with the help of a friend, I compiled a list of questions that will help most of you who are completely unknown and strange to the world of voiceovers and want to know a little bit about it, alright? So, this is by no means a tutorial to sort of make you an expert. But yes, if you're sort of curious about it, it'll give you a good idea about how to go about things. So, without wasting any further time, question number one is there an age limit to pursue a voiceover course or take it as a profession? The answer is no. You can do it pretty much at any point of your life, all right? Whether you're young, whether you're middle-aged, whether you're old, whether in your whether if you're in your teens, whether in your 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, as long as you have a voice, as long as you have expression, and as long as you have a love to do voice acting, which is what basically voiceovers is, you should go for it, all right? And there's a requirement, there's a market for child voices, there's a requirement for young voices, there's a requirement for baritone voices. There is a requirement for high-pitched voices. There's a requirement for old voices. There's a requirement for every kind of voice. All right, but I'm not going to get into details about how you can get to that market. That's some hard work that you have to do. You have to go in your local scene. You have to find out which are the studios, what kind of work are they doing, where do you fit into that work that they are doing. All right, so it's not as simple as, you know, just opening a book and sab kuch ho gaya ek tarah. Aapko mehnat bhi karni padegi. Is there an age limit? No age limit. All right. Question two. Basic tips and important points to remember while doing a voiceover. All right. No matter how experienced you are, all right, nobody is ever above rehearsing a script. All right. A lot of people say that, you know, yaar, kya voiceover artist hai yaar? Ek second mein aake isne, kya baat hai dost, kya baat hai? No, this is not, you know, एक लोहार की दिस इज अ सौ सोनार की सॉर्ट ऑफ अ वर्क वेयर यू हैव टू गो थ्रू योर स्क्रिप्ट नो मैटर व्हाट यू आर डूइंग यू हैव टू गो थ्रू इट यू हैव टू मार्क द पॉजेस द स्ट्रेसेस यू हैव टू गो थ्रू प्रोनाउंसिएशन यू हैव टू नो अबाउट व्हाट इट इज दैट यू आर स्पीकिंग अबाउट ऑलराइट सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू हैव अ कॉर्पोरेट फिल्म वेयर यू नो द पीपल विल बी सिटिंग इन अ बोर्ड रूम देन यू कांट बी स्पीकिंग लाइक दिस एज इफ लाइक यू नो इट्स अ वेरी कैजुअल एंड चिल्ड आउट एटमॉस्फेयर नो and at the same time, if you're, say, doing a voiceover for something like a bag of chips, you can't be sounding all corporate, all right? So, you have to do your homework, you have to do your research, you have to know what are the kind of people who will be listening to this voiceover, and accordingly, you have to do your preparation, all right? Go through the script, mark your pauses, mark your stresses, know about the client, if possible, visit the website. I know if you're just landing up in a studio and you've just been given a script, ekdam se time nahi milta, but yaar, aajkal mobile phone har ek ke paas hote hain, Wi-Fi har studio mein hota hai, 3G, 4G, har jagah aa jata hai. It'll take you 2 minutes, alright? And it'll give, like, the client who's going to approve your work, you know, a very good impression if you sound, you know, the way they want you to sound. And all of it is research. So, pronunciations, okay, how can you know about the pronunciation? There's a very good site for English, at least, which is Oxford Dictionary. You go there, you type any word, and it'll give you a pronunciation. And there are lots of apps, okay? Merriam-Webster is what I've been using on my iPhone. I'm sure it's there for different platforms like Android, etc. My phone is ringing, but I have already started this video, so I'm not going to leave it now. Okay, So basic important tips are that all right, so also drink a lot of water, because if you don't drink a lot of water, then your mouth will make like these type sounds, which are not very nice when it comes to a voiceover. All right, sit comfortably, be well rehearsed, go through the script, practice it like, you know, at least 4, 5, 6 times if possible. जो जितना भी आपको थोड़ा सा टाइम मिलता है, इफ यू हैव द लग्जरी ऑफ गेटिंग द स्क्रिप्ट, यू नो, अ डे और अ फ्यू डेज बिफोर, देन एक्सेलेंट. इफ इट्स बीन सेंट टू योर स्टूडियो, देन इवन बेटर. आपके पास कोई टेंशन नहीं है, कोई क्लाइंट नहीं है, कोई रिकॉर्डिस्ट नहीं है आपके सर पे, आप आराम से तसली से बैठ के यू कैन गो थ्रू इट. ऑलराइट, या सो बेसिकली रिहर्स द स्क्रिप्ट, प्रिपेयर, मार्क इट. व्हाट आई डू इज लाइक, वेर एवर आई वॉन्ट अ पॉज इन बिटवीन अ सेंटेंस, आई पुट अ स्लैश बिटवीन टू वर्ड्स, एंड देन आई नो दैट अच्छा मुझे यहाँ पे पॉज लेना है. एंड इफ देर इज अ स्ट्रेस, ओके, दैट यू हैव टू पुट ऑन अ सर्टन वर्ड, लाइक अ ब्रांड नेम, लाइक यू नो, सो आई अंडरलाइन इट. सो आई नो दैट वेर एवर देर इज अ स्लैश, देर इज अ पॉज, एंड वेर एवर देर इज अ अंडरलाइन थिंग, आई हैव टू स्ट्रेस दैट वर्ड. ऑलराइट, सो स्ट्रेसेस एंड पॉजेस are very, very important, all right, because the modulation, you know, the way that you change the script, how you give it character, is basically the quality of a voiceover. All right, you have a nice voice, you might have a nice voice, you might not have a nice voice, but the thing is, how do people feel when you say a certain voiceover, how when you speak a certain voiceover, how do they feel? That's basically it. Usi ka sara khel hai. Like, you know, if you say something in a way that affects nobody, then it's going to be a problem. All right. Question number three, things to remember while recording at home and in the studio, difference between the two. Very, very good. Very, very, very good question. Okay. Things to remember while recording at home. Whenever I enter my studio, I dress up like I'm going to work. All right. So this is my CBS den. I dress up like I'm actually going to work. Okay. I wake up in the morning. I have a bath. You know, I comb my hair, I put on shoes sometimes, I wear nice clothes, I come here like it's my workplace, not like it's my bedroom, okay? So this is something that you have to understand. When you're recording in your own place, just because it's your own place doesn't mean that you treat it like it's your bedroom. You have the same mindset. No. If there were 30, 40, 50 people in an office, aap wahan kaise jaoge? Aapko yahan pe waise aana hai. That is the kind of mind frame that you enter your studio with, all right? Just because it's your studio doesn't mean that time is not precious. Doesn't mean that jahan aapko 15 minute lagne, aap 3 ghante mein ek cheez kaam karoge. Okay, you have to be very, very concerned about your time, because turnaround times are a very, very important thing when it comes to voiceovers. If you're going to take like, you know, 2 hours or 3 hours to give back something which might have taken a normal artist 15, 20 minutes, then trust me, the client is going to prefer that person over you the next time around. Be very, very concerned about the amount of time that you spend in the studio. Come in, do your job, get out. You know, don't like chill out and take your time, and, you know, be very, very concerned about the amount of time that you are spending when you are at home. Things to remember while recording at home and in the studio. Okay, so these are the things that you remember when you're recording at home. Okay, when you have a script at home, you have the time, you have the luxury, so you can mark all your stuff and you can do things a little more casually and like, you know, but your seriousness has to be the same. Okay, of course, the other things that you have to keep in mind while having a home studio is that you need to keep your equipment updated. Okay, if possible, get a few people in to see what you are doing, and they can give you advice. Okay. Shantanu Hudlegar sir, who is the chief engineer, main most important person in Yash Raj Sound Studios. Okay, I was just sharing a photo and he told me something as small as just keep the speakers, you know, behind your table and give it a little depth, and that will change the way you hear things. It was such a small thing that he told me, and it has completely changed my whole understanding of how I'm doing my work as a person who's mixing tracks. Okay, so something as small as that. So get somebody in, if possible, share the photos of your setup with other people who are doing it. You know, Pralay Bakshi is a guy who is now in Goa. Okay, he's also a voiceover artist, radio professional, thorough gentleman. He had taught me a lot of, like, he basically talked to me about, you know, how I can do some things regarding soundproofing and, like, you know, him. And then there's a guy called Krishnikant Bhatt, who is from Haldwani. him. And like, I have so many friends who actually helped me. Like, you know, people look at CBS Den and they're like, wow, dude, how are you, like, you know, making this sound in this little place? And I'm like, dude, I'm not the only person who's responsible for it. There are so many people who've actually helped me out, and it's because of their hard work that, you know, now I understand what I do. So yes, when you're at home, don't just like, you know, keep confined in your little space and just think that whatever it is that you know is the only thing that you require. Sometimes the help and advice from people also matters a lot, okay? So in case there is something else, you can just write in the comments if I've forgotten to pick up something. But these are the things that are coming to the top of my head, things to remember home. Soundproofing is very important. So if you live in a noisy place, it will be very difficult for you to have a home studio. I am lucky enough because mere ghar ke piche sirf there's a huge garden and there is not much noise in our colony as such. Things to remember when recording in a studio. Right? Don't get nervous, okay? Because when you're at this side, you know, and there's like a mirror, there's like a shisha and glass, and there are people sitting at that side, and you know, there's a lot of pressure and people are looking at you, and you fumble and you make a little few mistakes, and then you feel like the whole world is going to fall on your head, okay? Don't feel like that, okay? Don't, I mean, I know it's very simple for me to say that, but be confident in what you have rehearsed, remember what you have prepared, and go with the script, okay? And don't get intimidated by like the whole studio environment, which is why I say that, you know, a lot of people want to do voiceovers, but very few of them actually go to a studio to get their demos made. Unko lagta hai ki yaar seedha jaake na kaam milna start ho jayega aur hum uber cool ho jayenge overnight. Aisa nahi hota hai. Theek hai, go to a studio, rehearse, spend some money, get some nice demos made, sit with somebody who's done this before, you know, spend some time, ask them, talk to them. I mean, ye video to ban gaya hai, but you know, like, kitne log hain jo ye video nahi dekhenge. So, I just hope that, you know, more people would actually go to a studio and spend time there. Also, when you're in a studio, just communicate very, like, as aapki communication jitni achhi rahegi with the person who's recording you, aapka output utna achha rahega, and the process will be easier, not just for you, but also for the technician, okay? So, and also be very, very polite and nice and sweet to the people who are recording you. Not just because if they don't like you, they can make you sound like crap and you can't do anything about it. You won't even know what they've done. Okay, this is a very thankless sort of a profession of a sound engineer where people just expect you to do everything. And, you know, so if you are actually nice to that person who's recording you, he will go to long lengths to make sure that what you're doing is nice. So it's very important to be nice to these studio professionals who are recording you and who are, you know, sitting there very patiently while you take all the takes that you take. So be respectful to people who are there in the studio. Communicate nicely. Tell them if you can't hear yourself or if you're too loud or something like that, you know, like that. Then if you're using a condenser microphone like this one, then of course you need to have a pop filter. If you don't have a pop filter, then you need to angle it in a way that, you know, your B's and P's and T's, you know, the I forget the word, but yeah, basically the sounds which have a burst of air, which like just like, you know, moves from your mouth. Anyway, so yeah, so those words, a pop filter will make sure that those bursts of air don't touch the mic and make noise, all right? So positioning the mic is something that you need to get used to. Just like, you know, like placing yourself near a mic and holding a script in your hand and speaking with comfort. And these things are things that you will only understand once you go in a studio and you record, all right? So there is no bypassing that. Try to be timely. If there are 3-4 artists and all of them need to be recorded, and you know, so don't be extra critical. Ek hota hai, do type ke kaam hote hai. Ek hota hai moti pirone wala kaam. Aur ek hota hai chhapai wala kaam. Chhapai wala kaam wo hota hai jo 2 minute pe karke khatam ho jata hai. Moti pirone wala hota hai jo jispe log, you know, 4-4 mahine lage pade hote hain, par yaar wo perfection nahi aa raha. So you don't want to be the moti pirone wala guy who like spends abnormal amount of time to do one voiceover. And you also don't want to be that chapai wala person who just, you know, does pat 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 and runs away. So take time, but don't take so much time because other people will get irritated then. Okay, that'll add to the pressure. Okay, next question. Can one consider voiceover as a profession or should it be kept as a hobby? Well, it completely depends on the amount of work that you're able to generate. All right. So if you have so much work as a voiceover artist that you don't have time for anything else, then and if the money is good, then of course, you don't have a choice. You've already made it your profession. All right. But if you think that you are not able to, for whatever reasons, you know, and the reasons could be many, if you're not able to actually get too much work or people are not responding very well and aapko lag raha hai ki aap hi dhakka de rahe ho, or you know, like you're just trying to push something that's not happening, sometimes it's very difficult for us to understand that we are not meant for a certain profession. I'm not trying to discourage you, but if you're trying really hard for something and if it's not working out and if a lot of people have told you that nahi ho raha, toh there is no point trying to make it a profession, you know. It didn't happen, it didn't work out. Ab jaise aapka ek relationship hota hai, wo nahi chalta, toh that doesn't mean na that aap us insaan ke piche padi jao haath mein dhoke, aisa nahi hota, right? So agar, if it's not working out as a profession, then let it go. But if you're asking me if it can be made into a profession, yes, yes, yes. Okay, a lot of people have made it. I have made it, although I do a lot of other things as well. But if I was only doing voiceovers, I would be doing pretty well. But I also do music and I also do production and I also do radio. So if it is working out for you, if in your local market you have been able to make a reasonable amount of, you know, generate a reasonable amount of work, and if that work is steady, it's constant, it's not just a once in a while sort of a thing, yes, go for it, all right, you can. But agar wo cheez nahi ho rahi hai aur aap bahut zyada mehnat kar rahe ho aur agar wo cheez ho ke hi nahi de rahi, and if you've put like a number of years and if you've tried really hard and you've just done your best and it's not happening, give it up and move on to something else. You're probably wasting your time. Okay. Can a VO artist be selective in his or her genre? Should he or she be an all-rounder? There is nothing called an all-rounder. Okay, there is a something called a jack of all trades. All-rounder aaj tak koi nahi hua hai. And there is just somebody who mediocre kaam har cheez mein karta hai wo. Toh wo nahi karna hai. What you want to do is, you want to be an expert in one major, mota-mota niche area. So for example, me, I have done like radio voiceovers, anchor voices, for almost 5 to 6 years with one radio station, okay, in Hindi and in English, 92.7 Big FM. 92.7 Big FM, gaane jo hit the, hit rahenge. Anyway, so like, you know, I have done that. So I sort of have a specialization in that because I've done a lot of that. All right, I've also done a lot of corporate films. So I have a specialization in that. Of late, I've started doing e-learning. All right, so I really enjoy e-learning. Okay, people think it's geeky, but maybe I'm a geek, all right? So, then there are people who do dubbing, okay? I tried doing dubbing a little bit, but I'm just too impatient, okay? And plus that whole Hindi reading thing doesn't like, you know, happen with me. Wo bahut achhi wali jo Hindi hoti jo use karte hain log. And plus that whole visual syncing thing, it's just not my thing, okay? I've done it. If push comes to shove, I might do like some episodes, but it's not cut out for me, all right? But there are people who do voiceovers, there are people who do dubbing, there are people who do e-learning, there are people who do corporates, and they sort of specialize in that, okay? Like, for example, there is a very famous voiceover artist called Rana, okay? Now, he does that whole type voice for a lot of anchoring, like, radio anchor voices, for television anchor voices, and his very typical voice, like, obviously I don't have a voice like his, he's got his own voice, but he specializes in that, okay? Then there's another gentleman whose name I forget, I'm really bad with names, I'm really sorry, okay? But he specializes in these corporate films. So a lot of times when you hear these corporate films, you hear a very typical kind of a voice, you know, and then there are people who want to specialize in e-learning or whatever. So if you are a specialist, it's great, but don't start off with the idea of, you know, being a specialist, because first you have to try 1,000 things and you understand, achha, theek hai, my comfort zone is this, or this is, okay, so like, for example, I can't do shuddh Hindi voiceovers, okay, I can't, like, because that's not my area of specialization. I'm more comfortable with casual, आम बोलचाल की हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश. ऑलराइट, आई कैन डू दोज प्रीटी वेल. सो आई डोंट ट्राई टू अननेसेसरीली यू नो पिक अप लाइक हिंदी वॉइस ओवर्स बिकॉज आई एम नॉट वेरी गुड एट इट. ऑलराइट, सिमिलरली इफ यू आर समबडी हु इज वेरी कंफर्टेबल विद द हिंदी लैंग्वेज, प्लीज डोंट ट्राई टू अननेसेसरीली डू इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज बिकॉज यू जस्ट साउंड वेरी फनी एंड इवन पीपल हु लाइक यू एज अ हिंदी वॉइस ओवर आर्टिस्ट विल फॉर्म जजमेंट अबाउट यू एज बीइंग अ बैड वॉइस ओवर आर्टिस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव डन वेरी बैड यू नो अनदर लैंग्वेज वॉइस जो आपके बस की नहीं थी पहली बार. तो जस्ट स्टिक टू वॉट यू कैन डू एंड डू इट वेल. ऑलराइट, इज इट एसेंशियल फॉर अ वॉइस आर्टिस्ट टू बी टेक्निकली साउंड? It is not essential for, firstly, what do you mean by technically sound? Because you could be technically sound in a lot of areas. One, you could be technically sound in the language. Two, you could be technically sound in expression if you're an actor. Three, you could be technically sound in the techniques of recording or production. Yes, it has... इट इज इसेंशियल एंड आज नहीं तो कल आपको ये चीजें समझनी पड़ेंगी और सीखनी पड़ेंगी. ओके, यू हैव टू बी एन एक्सपर्ट इन योर लैंग्वेज. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट वर्ड मीन्स वॉट. दैट इज हाउ यू विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्रेस इट. यू हैव टू बी समबडी हु रीड्स अ लॉट. यू हैव टू बी समबडी हु अंडरस्टैंड्स undertones of language. So when I'm reading something, I understand that this is where this person is taking the script and this is the emotion which is underrunning these words on a printed paper that I'm reading. All right, so you have to be an expert. Obviously you have to be an expert when it comes to technology because technology ke through hi aap apni voice record karte ho. Agar aapko wohi cheeze samajh mein nahi aa rahi to aapko kya pata lega ki aapki voice kaisi sound kar rahi hai, aap usko kaise modulate kar sakte ho, change kar sakte ho, how can you reshape it, how will you understand these things. All right, so that's also a very important part. Technically, you have to be sound, especially when it comes to language, especially when it comes to projecting and expressing yourself, articulating yourself, and of course, when it comes to equipment. Ab ye sari ekdam se cheezein ek saath nahi hongi, theek hai? Time lagta hai. So, take your own time, okay? If somebody can teach you these things, wonderful, alright? If there's a course, I'm not very aware of a lot of radio courses. So, if there is some course which is imparting all these skills, then go for it. Amazing. Okay. What would be an approximate gestation period for stabilizing oneself in this field? That's like asking, I've just started learning the guitar. How long before I become a successful, steady, money-making person? Dude, this is a skill. Okay, this is not just speaking, holding a paper in your hand. If it was that easy, everybody would be a voiceover artist. Why is everybody not a voiceover artist? Because this thing takes time. Okay, this thing takes energy. It takes a number of years. It takes pursuing, you know, studio professionals for months, hoping that they'll like your voice, hoping that they will approve your voice somewhere, hoping that the client likes it, hoping that they call you back. Okay, it's not as simple as aap gaye style while marke, yo, this is my demo and I want some work. Doesn't work like that. There are already people who are in this field who've been working hard much before you, who are far more successful than you, who know everything about everything when it comes to voiceovers. Okay, and they are already making money. Why the hell would anybody give you a chance? So, asaan to nahi hai. Time to lagega. Theek hai? But ye hai, you are asking me, what is the approximate gestation period for stabilizing oneself in this field? I am asking you a question. How much patience do you have before you change your mind? How much patience do you have? Are you going to give it up just because you didn't get any work for the first 2 months? Are you going to give it up because pehle baar jis bande ne aapko kaam diya usne bola yaar free mein kar de, mere paas paisa nahi hai. Yeah, what? Like, what is your patience level actually, you know? So, this is a wrong question to ask actually. The more you do it, the better you will become. Okay. Maybe your growth will be slower or faster than the people you know. But it will take time. So, this is just a stupid question. Okay. Sorry. You have to be patient. You have to work hard. And aapka success, aapki ability pe depend karta hai. Theek hai? If you can pick it up fast, if you can modulate yourself well. You know, a lot of people have these ideas about themselves that I think I'm superb. I kick ass in my head, all right? But when it comes to reality, na, एक तो ये कैमरा होता है, यू आर लुकिंग एट द वर्ल्ड, एक होता है जो द वर्ल्ड इज लुकिंग एट यू. ओके, सो व्हाट यू थिंक अबाउट योरसेल्फ डजंट मैटर एट ऑल. ओके, व्हाट पीपल थिंक अबाउट यू मैटर्स, व्हाट द क्लाइंट्स थिंक अबाउट यू मैटर्स, व्हाट 10,000 पीपल थिंक अबाउट योर वॉइस, दैट इज व्हाट मैटर्स. सो व्हाट यू थिंक अबाउट योरसेल्फ डजंट मैटर एट ऑल. ओके, सो जस्ट कीप दैट इन माइंड, बी पेशेंट. होना होगा तो होगा, नहीं होना तो नहीं होगा, पर ये नहीं है कि यार ओके सो लेट मी जस्ट मार्क माय टाइमर इन माय लिटिल वॉच, 6 months लेटर इफ आई एम नॉट हैप्पी देन आई move to the next best thing that comes along because I haven't made any decisions till now in my life. Aise nahi hota, you have to be patient. Okay. Input on how one can keep their voice intact for years to come. Excellent question. Sleep for 8 hours a day. Okay. Have plenty of water. Plenty of water. Generally keep yourself healthy if possible. I mean, I'm like overweight and I need to take care of my health too, and all of us might have, you know, different things, but yes, of course, things like excessive smoking, excessive coffee, extreme temperatures ka khana, bahut zyada thanda bahut zyada khana, bahut zyada garam bahut zyada khana, bahut zyada spicy khana, I mean, once in a while it's fine, yeah, but also the voice is a muscle, so you know, you don't want to overstrain it. At the same time, you also don't want to underwork it. So you have to keep all these things in mind, all right? So take care. Sleep and I think water and food are the three things. And generally, if you keep yourself healthy, then that's great. I think cardiovascular exercise is great because it keeps your, you know, your heart, your breathing system and everything in check. And that's great because your breathing is a huge part of your speaking and your voice. All right. So that's another thing. How can an amateur VO artist promote or market himself or herself post a VO course? Okay. The first thing to do is if the VO course has helped you make a professional demo, then you take that demo to places and you try to, you know, let people know about what you have done. I think the best way to actually market yourself is online, you know, because a lot of people are online. Get in touch with them. Also, you know, like if you're passionate about it, course ke saath kaam khatam nahi ho jata. Like course aapko ek level of knowledge dega. You have to keep doing your research. You have to keep doing your practice. Okay, buy a little small audio interface, get yourself a microphone, record yourself at home, you know, make a DIY little sound booth or something, reflection filter or something, like, you know, keep doing your stuff. Don't just depend on the professional opportunities you get. Do your stuff at home, you know, open the television, look at the radio, look at the television, open the radio, hear things, write down scripts, you know, record them in your voice, make demos, collaborate with other voiceover artists, see what they are doing. Don't be all like, you know, threatening ki, oh, I am better than you and you are better than me and, oh, you're getting more work, I'm getting less work. Aisa nahi hai. Collaborate with them, you know. Do something in which both of your voices are highlighted. Aajkal, things go viral online, you know. Make something, come up with some creative concept, you know, collaborate with people. Make someone write something interesting for you. Get another artist, you know. Tell them that, hey man, let's record that, or yeah, let's record this and, you know, let's project it. And, you know, join all these voiceover groups online, because sometimes some project keeps popping up and somebody suddenly needs a voiceover artist and that is the moment. But most important of all this is please go to a professional studio, get yourself a demo made, pay some 5,000, 10,000 bucks to someone, tell him to write scripts for you, record you, make it sound good and give it to you, so that at least aapke paas kuch to hoga jab aap logon ko dikhaoge. You should have something to show to people. Okay. You have to keep visiting these places. You have to keep calling up these people and don't overdo it. But yes, like regularly try to call them up, you know. Go meet people. And, you know, marketing yourself is not a trick, yaar. It's not like, you know, it's not a scam. Ki humne ye kar liya toh hum market rahenge. The thing is, the best way to market yourself is just to be a reasonable and a good human being. If people like you, you know, half your job is already done. If nobody likes you, you can do the best marketing in the world and you'll still be like, you know, somebody who nobody likes and nobody wants to work with. Okay, so just be a good human being, try to be reasonable with people, try to be nice, Be friendly, you know. Go to your studios, whichever people you know. Try to make contacts, you know. Like, for example, I know a lot of female voiceover artists who are not threatened. So I always tell them that, you know, agar koi female ki requirement hogi, I'll give you a number. And, you know, likewise, they also do the same. So if they get to hear of any opportunity where a male voiceover artist is required, you know, they recommend me. So that's also something that can work out for you. Cite the basic differences between voiceovers and RJing on radio. Okay, I think that's the last question. So I'm going to quickly do this before my battery dies. Okay, voiceovers and radio are completely different. Completely different. A guy might be a excellent radio jockey, but will completely fail at voiceovers. Or somebody might be a very good voiceover artist and he'll not know what the hell to do in a radio console. Okay, so what is the difference between the two? A voiceover artist rehearses, prepares a script. There is a goal that he needs to reach in terms of articulation, in terms of voice modulation, in terms of delivery. And he needs to do it in a specific period of time. Okay, that is voiceover. Radio has nothing to do with your voice. I'll say that again. Radio has nothing to do with your voice. Okay, voiceovers may, voice quality matters. You need to have a great baritone and blah, blah, blah. Okay, or you might have a sexy voice and that'll be great for voiceovers. When it comes to radio, people are more interested in your personality. People are more interested in the way that you think, the things that you know, your level of awareness of your city. You know, aapke city mein kya ho raha hai, kya nahi ho raha hai. All those things, okay, it's more to do with content, it's more to do with, you know, your ability to think on your feet, your ability to connect with people, you know, how much can you understand people, and how much can people understand you, you know, so that is what radio is about. Okay, so this is not a question which is there, but it's just come to my mind. A lot of people think, yaar, main na bahut talkative hoon. मेरे दोस्त ना बोलते हैं चुप हो जा, तुझे तो रेडियो पे होना चाहिए, तू तो कितनी बोलती है. हाँ, ओके, टू बी टॉकेटिव इज वन थिंग एंड टू बी अ रेडियो प्रोफेशनल इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट. ऑन रेडियो वी गेट अराउंड 45 सेकेंड्स थ्री टाइम्स इन एन आवर इन विच वी हैव टू कम्युनिकेट अ लॉट. यू नो वॉट दैट रिक्वायर्स? दैट रिक्वायर्स प्रेजेंस ऑफ माइंड, दैट रिक्वायर्स क्विकनेस ऑफ वॉइस, एंड दैट रिक्वायर्स द एबिलिटी टू समराइज. The ability to summarize your words, okay? So, ये जो एक concept है ना लोगों का कि यार तुम बतियाते बहुत हो, तो maybe you should be on radio. It's completely wrong. Okay, I think that wraps up for today. If you have any more questions or if you like this video, please comment, share, like, subscribe. And yeah, that's it. Bye!